know why I did that.
Welcome. What am I making? A video. Planning my videos isn't something that I've always done. I'd have a brief idea of the type of video I'd want to make. I'd go out and shoot it, and I'd get a bunch of this one clip and not enough of this other clip. And I'd come back to realize that I've completely missed elements that were really important to tell a proper story. Taking the time to plan your videos will not only save you time during the shoot, but it will allow you to experience an event or a trip without being stuck behind the camera the entire time. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how I plan my videos, and we're gonna talk about how I tackle a vlog, but then also how I plan videos like this one as well. And huge thanks to MusicBed for sponsoring today's video. Why am I doing this with my hands? I'm just like, I literally look like just hands and a head. So every video has to start with an idea. And sometimes that idea is a tutorial or a question that needs to be answered, or sometimes there's just a story to be told. I have a long list of ideas for videos that I wanna make, but most weeks something will pop in my head that I want to make, or we're working on a project that will make a fun video and that ends up being the video for that week. But if I don't have a video idea and I'm not vibing off any of the ideas in my list, which happens often, then I do a little bit of a brainstorming session to try to produce some kind of cool idea that I might be able to make for you guys that's exciting and that I'm into. Okay, so let's just quickly do a brainstorm session real quick. This is just like off the top of my head. So I think about the things that I'm really into right now, really passionate about. So right now I'm always into interior design, but very passionate about interior design. So writing that down in a list, I could also say that maybe along with interior design, I'm really into coffee table books. And so maybe I could make a video about my top 5 favorite coffee table books, very into wool throw blankets. So maybe I could make a list of top 5 resources to find throw blankets. I don't think you guys would care about throw blankets, but maybe the coffee table book idea would work. And usually once I start rolling with an idea, then multiple ideas will start kind of popping off from that. I'll write them all down and then I'll pick a video to make. By the way, let me know if you'd like a video about my favorite coffee table books. But the key when you're doing brainstorming, or if an idea pops in your head, write it down. Like, don't just say, oh, I'll remember, because you're not gonna remember. Write it down, write it on your hand, write it on your forehead, whatever you have to do to remember it. So before I start doing any research on whatever YouTube video I'm making, the story comes first. So I ask myself 2 things. What is this video going to be about? And the second question is, what is the key takeaway from this video? So we'll use our YouTube journey video as an example right now. If you wanna check it out, I'll link it up here. Let's answer the questions about that video. What is this video going to be about? The video is about our YouTube journey, showing our timeline from where we started to how we got to 100K, and showing non-numerical milestones along the way. And the key takeaway from that video was to encourage people to start their own channels and to show the realities behind how long it actually takes to grow a YouTube channel. So once I've answered those 2 questions, what the video is gonna be about and what is the key takeaway, I'll start to plan out the beginning, middle, and end of said video. So once I have the concept for the video and a brief idea of what the outline is gonna be, I'll start to wrap my head around the title and the thumbnail. Then I hit YouTube and do a bit of research based on the content of the video. So I'll look up what the topic of the video I'm going to make is, and I'll see what's performing good, what thumbnails are working, what isn't working, what titles are working. And then I'll just do a brain dump of keywords and title ideas of things that I think could work from a performance standpoint, but then also from a video standpoint that gives you guys an idea, a good clear idea of what the video is gonna be about. Once I start to nail down a few solid title ideas, then I can kind of start finalizing my thumbnail. And this all happens usually before I shoot anything. So this might be the designer in me, but I actually like to sketch out some of my thumbnails before I actually work on them. For the vlog, not so much, because those are kind of run and gun videos. I'll usually use a photo and a template that I've designed, and that's what the thumbnail is for the most part. But for other videos, if I'm shooting a photo, I like to sketch it out first so I know what kind of photo I want to use, because the photo I use is probably gonna dictate my type layout. So sketching sometimes helps me visualize, do I need a minimalist shot? Do I need kind of like an offset, you know, left aligned shot? I need space up top or space below? So sketching really helps, especially when we're doing more short film stuff or more series stuff where we want to develop sort of a template so all the thumbnails look similar across the board. That's when it's really important to do this, to plan it, to sketch it, because if you're doing a series and all the thumbnails are gonna look the same, then you're gonna wanna shoot photos for each of those videos that work with your thumbnail template. And not always am I shooting something specific for a video that's like the ideal scenario, but sometimes I do forget to shoot a thumbnail and I'll just pull a screen grab right from the video. Not ideal, but I've done it. So once I have my thumbnail and my title idea, I go back to the questions that I've answered at the beginning about my story, and then I start to develop an outline. I usually use Milanote for this, and I start by writing a short paragraph answering what is the point of this video, and that helps me wrap my head around the planning and the outline and figure out what exactly I need to include in the video and what doesn't need to be in the video. So for this video, I'm gonna read it because I have it written down here. What is the point of this video? Take a peek behind the scenes into what it takes to plan a YouTube video every week and show there's much more that goes into it than just an idea. Every video, I do that. And then from there, I start writing rough notes on what I want to include in the video and some talking points, and that all kind of circles back to the point of the video. So depending on the kind of video I'm making, this is where things kind of change a little bit. For a weekly vlog, it's definitely more run and gun. So I kind of stick to a first this, then this format. I'll make a really rough outline with a couple of talking points that I want to hit, but I don't plan it out too much. I have an idea of what the story is going to be so I know what to shoot, but it's not overly planned, where a video like this is much more structured. If we're making something a little more polished, like a short film or a docuseries, sort of like The City That Changed Our Life, which I'll leave up here, link up here. Then we go much deeper with writing scripts, writing an outline, storyboarding it, setting up talking shots, doing voiceovers. It's a little more involved. We actually made a video on MusicBed's channel outlining how we made that specific film. So I'll also link that one up here, which brings me to today's sponsor. Thank you so much, MusicBed, for sponsoring today's video. When we're planning our videos, sometimes a certain song will spark an idea for an edit. You hear the song, you just visualize the entire thing. We love browsing MusicBed's high quality selection of tracks from talented emerging artists and composers to find tracks that inspire our edits. Their robust search function makes it super easy to find great tracks. We're planning a video for the fall, and we're actually picking all the songs beforehand to deliver on a certain vibe. And being able to search for specific genres, attributes, and moods allows us to find the right tracks for our videos quickly and then build out a playlist from there. MusicBed is not a royalty-free platform, but you get a license for every track you download, so you are 100% cleared and legal to use the tracks in your YouTube videos. Their custom sync ID tech clears everything in the back end, so you never lose out on revenue. Use our coupon code Becky and Chris at checkout to get your first month free when you sign up for an annual individual subscription. Thank you so much, MusicBed, for being a constant supporter of this channel. Once I know what the story is gonna be and I have an outline created, I create a brief shot list to make sure I capture everything I need to tell a story. And that includes the thumbnail image as well. I'll make two lists depending on the video, a video shot list and a photo shot list. And that photo shot list sometimes is just for Instagram photos, for a number of thumbnail options. And the video shot list is all of the things I need to make that story happen. And within that shot list, I make sure that every shot that's there is necessary in telling that story, and it's not just not unnecessary shots for the sake of B-roll. Everything serves a purpose in the video. So once I have my shot list done, I know exactly what the story is gonna be. Then we actually go and shoot the video. Again, sometimes those shots are gonna be more meticulously planned out, say for a documentary type video or for a short film. And other times they're just gonna be more run and gun. If I write down vlog style, that kind of just means run and gun, document, rough, plus shoot whatever B-roll is necessary to get the story across. If I find myself in a situation that I haven't planned for, which happens a lot, especially with the helicopter videos, but the story or the trip or the adventure is kind of going in a way that might be more interesting than what I had planned originally, then I kind of just run with it. Something I keep in mind in the back of my head all the time, especially when this happens, then I kind of rely on what I call the seven shot sequence. I go through this list to make sure that I capture enough footage of what's happening to A, tell a story and to make a solid sequence. And that looks like this. So one wide shot to establish the scene. So that could be like a time lapse, a drone shot, a stationary shot. Then I go for two wide slash medium shots, and those shots will kind of show what's happening. Then I go for two close-up shots to show details. One abstract shot, so like a macro shot, a fast panning motion, and then one unexpected shot. I'll shoot each of those for 10 seconds to make sure that I have enough that I can compile a sequence. And that usually will get me by in any situation. So this is typically how I plan all of my videos. Depending on the style of video will depend on how much planning goes into it. For a vlog, it's more run and gun and rough with rough talking points. For a video like this, it's gonna be a little bit more meticulous with a full outline with talking points. And then of course, for a short film, we're doing scripts, we're doing storyboards, we're doing shot lists, full in-depth shot lists. So it kind of goes in little tiers. For a tutorial, we're typically using a teleprompter for something like that. We usually try to script that out as best we can and then pop the teleprompter on the camera and use that. And that just helps us make sure that we deliver the exact and correct information to you guys, especially if we're teaching something we don't want to be, you know, saying the wrong thing. And we use a Parrot teleprompter for that, and that is super helpful. So we come up with the idea, then we develop a story, research titles and thumbnails. Then we make a video outline with simple talking points and a brief shot list. We shoot the video and then we edit the video and then we put it out for you guys. I actually made a video a few weeks ago sharing my entire Premiere Pro workflow, how I edit a video from start to finish. So if you are curious and you want to check that video out, I'll link it up here. If there's no room left, it'll be in the description box. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thanks MusicBed for sponsoring today's video. We'll catch you in the next one. Non-numerical thumbnails. The beginning middle video. Excuse me. Black sweater is just like making me disappear into the background, but I really like wearing black. I really like how black walls. Kind of a catch-22.
See ya!